My faculty mentor and I, from the get-go, knew that we would want to publish it in a journal. We're thinking of, they're called a supplement series, which is they publish articles that are more data-driven and have less analysis. So we've always kind of had that goal in mind. And in pursuing that, I've presented at various conferences to kind of gauge if my research is relevant and interesting to the field. And then another thing that we hope to do is publish all my data online, so that if people do read the article and they want access to the data, that's the whole point of our research, is to give them that access. So we'd like to post that all online for people to access and use.
Dr. Fair and I, pretty initially after I started my literature review and the initial research, had discussed writing a publication. We've spent a lot of my years working on that. I had to find which journal I wanted to submit it to, and I found my favorite researcher for my personal research is Miles Balfe, so I decided to pick his journals that he submitted a lot of his work to. So we are working on an article I'm presenting at SURF, and as well as NCUR. So for us, it's just really getting that information out to the student body, and then in addition to my own research, I created a pamphlet for students with type 1 diabetes, and it will hopefully be in the Student Health Center by the end of this year. It has a section for students with diabetes, so just things, advice for them on how to deal with it, how to cope with it, because it is a very different condition, and it's very individualized, so you need to be prepared for what's going to happen for you. And then there's a second part, which is how to talk to your roommates about it. And that's what sets my research apart from a lot of the previous research, because a lot of the previous research is solely on students' experiences. And mine goes a step further and addresses how you interact with your roommates and how you come to those conclusions on addressing how you want to cope with it, but also keeping your roommate in the loop, because that is a very different setting than most students have been in prior to this.
When I've talked to my mentor about sharing the results, it's been, firstly, we focused on the fact that you can't give individual results. A lot of participants will want just their individual results, and that's not really something we can do. But we've also talked about the ways to, you know, draw conclusions from this research, and so we can look at our sample and say we've had 28 families, so we can't generalize it to everyone. You can really only talk about the types of families that we've worked with, and it is such a small sample that even then it's not generalizable to everyone. I think that's really important to realize before you go and make those conclusions with everyone else.
When Dr. Fair told me that we should start looking at journals to submit an article for, I can't describe the feeling. It was really empowering to know that I'm just an undergraduate student, but my mentor has enough confidence in my abilities, my writing, my research, that she's willing to put her name on the line to submit my work. So it was really reassuring feeling to know that, yeah, I'm doing this for me as a personal journey, but I'm also doing this and I can help other students and kids with diabetes to really learn how to cope with it, and I can share the story I've found. And I think it's a really cool feeling to know that people across the world may be able to read my work in a couple of months.